Angora!
Whoa! Whoa! What's happening? Everyone!
What's going on?
Something's burning.
Dodge me! Over here! Stay out of the light! Get out! Hurry! Hurry!
Time has returned to us.
Kaim, do you feel it?
It feels different. The force that pervades my body is from our world.
We're not letting you get away, Gungora!
Oh, I'm not going anywhere. There is no better place for me to fight immortals than here.
What?
In this light, it's like being in a part of our own world. Here, beyond the mirrors, time flows normally. We are no longer immortal. In this light, one could say, death lives.
Oh, that's so stupid.
Death lives.
But Grand Staff has fallen! What's left for you?
You do not understand. I have conquered Ura and vanquished Golsa. This magic energy will be enough to annihilate the Queen of Numara and gain the throne of the gods!
If that's the only answer you come to after a millennium, there's no future for you!
A millennium? What will it be like to die after living a millennium? First, I shall deal with you who stand in my way. Then, I shall destroy these cursed mirrors! This light that leads us to our death is now the source of life for a mighty beast. This great beast, born of powerful magic energy, do you think your puny magic can possibly defeat it?
Check it out!
Estimate our 1,000 years.
Don't forget, you're no different than us.
Yes, your fear of death exists here just like ours.
Me? I am fearful?
Your desire for some grand throne of the gods shows your fear.
Nonsense! Do not fear death. Death is my existence as a god! Are you fools ready to battle this god?
Is this when you thought you'd seen everything? Great.
Yes, in here!
Yeah! Thank you. Okay. Okay.
That's enough! Drop the barrier!
I'm trying, but something's not... I'm not sure what's wrong.
It won't go away!
What's going on? Check it out!
It's magic energy! Yeah. The magic energy that formed the barrier! Yeah. It's causing the power to increase! It's eating through!
This is bad! Time is moving faster!
What do we do?
No, no, no!
It's happening again! Not again!
Looks like we're gonna be mummies before we lose our clothes.
For a little while.
No! You have to get out!
I don't think that's gonna happen.
Jensen! We'll be okay. Mom is waiting for us. I'm sure we'll see you in the aurora.
Don't talk like that!
No! Sid! Get up!
I can't move anymore. Your Christmas. I'm older than you, you know.
Sid!
Mama. It looks like I'm gone before you.
Stop talking like that!
Declaring my love to you at the end before dying. Noble. Isn't it? I always wanted to play the dying hero, but really not really. I don't feel good. Any thoughts?
Jensen.
I love you, Ming.
Break the mirrors!
Seth!
It's all right.
I don't think we should stay here any longer.
Let's go.
Yeah, right.
It's locked. It won't move.
Whoa. What's that?
What's happening?
Go? What are you, nuts?
It's loosened up.
Right, good move.
I don't feel the rudder.
It's Seth. Yes. Yes, it is.
Mama? She's here now? Just when I had finally found you.
Sarah?
Hmm?
Seth isn't dead, is she?
No. She went home to her own world.
Is that not the same as death for an immortal?
In a sense, yes. Seth. Until we meet again.
Dear Seth, are you well? A quiet normalcy has at last returned to this world. Even now, in all kinds of places, people are meeting, parting, smiling, crying, raging, grieving. Filled with all kinds of emotions everywhere. Looking back at it all, what this world has is imagination. It would be too much to say that this world was created by such imagination. You should also know that we have once again been infected by the virus of emotions, but I will cherish the experience of them now. It was feelings, after all, that allowed me to love Kine. I have no desire to reject these thoughts. You remember Cook and Mac? Liram entrusted these sweet jewels to Kine and me. We are now all four of us, living in Liram's old house. Our life is so ordinary. But those everyday things are more fun than I would have imagined. Tolton returned to his place as king. He and Ming both asked Kaim for help in governing, but he turned them down, and we bought a large farm. We're leading a much simpler life, working with other farmers in the area to grow what each season allows us to. And for me, once I see Kaim and the children off each morning, I continue to write my history of magic energy, one page at a time. Given all that I have seen of this world, I want to leave a proper record.
All right.
Oh, I nearly forgot. We have big news. Something fun is about to happen. Something that'll make history. Today, we have another celebration.
Yo!
Hi!
What a great looking family!
Sid!
Hi, Sid!
Thanks for picking us up! Sid!
Good to see you again!
Hi, Sid!
I'm telling you, you guys sure are demanding. What am I? Your chauffeur?
That's right, Chet
Major. Come on aboard! Dan! Are we late?
Not to worry.
Do we, Bruss?
I don't know. Lately, Tolton has turned into a real kingly type of guy. Everything is organized down to the last detail. He's got a schedule for everything. Hey, he might have started already.
bride and groom shall step forward. Jensen Freed, do you take Ming Numara as your wife, promising to love her for all eternity?
I do.
Ming Numara, do you take Jensen Freed as your husband, promising to love him for all eternity?
I do.
Please seal your promise with a kiss.
Kiss?
Yeah, this is my favorite part.
Oh. All these people. Gotta make this look good. King Jensen. I mean, I cannot believe this is happening to me.
King Tolkien also have a promise to make. As a friend and as the ruler of Ura, as of this moment, I will do my best to restore the world to its native state, filled with love and mercy.
Congratulations are in order, Mama. I know you can see this.
So, Sarah, shall we try for another millennium?
I'd like that. I'm so happy, Kaim.
I don't think the memories will be as painful as they were in the last one.
So once we've raised the children as Lyrum asked, then what?
We can take it easy. Eternity's not so bad.
Sweet mother dear.